You should have the virtual CDRW DMG file, the disk image. Safari may automatically mount the disk image for you, but if not, just double click it and the disk image will mount. Once it's mounted, it opens automatically. You can see the registration app, the installer, and the uninstaller. To install the virtual CD, just double click the installer. Click the button titled Continue. Click the button titled Install. Because it's a kernel extension, you're going to have to enter your administrator password. Again, continue. And finally, because it's a kernel extension, you're going to have to restart your Mac. So after I restart my Mac, I'm going to come back and I'll show you what was installed. Okay guys, my Mac has restarted and now there's this new icon in the menu bar. This is the virtual CDRW menu. Simply click on it to see the virtual CDRW menu items. If we go back to the disk image for a second, there's a couple of things I wanted to show you. The first one is this document named Important Read First. This explains everything you need to know about the virtual CDRW. So please take 5 minutes to read through it and you'll save yourself a lot of time. And the other thing is the registration app, which is right here. If you do purchase the virtual CDRW and you'll get an email with your purchaser's ID and serial number, simply double click the registration app, enter your purchaser's ID, enter your serial number, click the register button and you're ready to go. So thank you for watching this video and I hope you enjoy using the virtual CDRW.